How fast can you render this scene in D5 Render? Hey everyone, today we'll be looking into the rendering speed of D5 Render. I will also be sharing with you where exactly you can download this 3D file. And of course, the steps on how to quickly achieve this type of rendered output. So sit back, relax, and make sure to watch till the end of this video. First, you need to have the following software: SketchUp, D5 Render, and Photoshop. Next, let's go to D5 Render's website. Go to the Assets Navigation tab and select Free 3D Asset Scene Download. All of these are free for you to test out and explore. Today, we'll be testing out this commercial scene right here. You have the download link, artist name, GPU, and workflow. SketchUp for modeling, D5 for rendering, and then Photoshop for post-production. Go ahead and click the link. It should then redirect you to WeTransfer. Click the download button, wait for it to finish, and then unzip the file. Once you're done unzipping the file, go inside the folder and browse its contents. You can also open up and explore the SketchUp file. Now, let's check out the D5 render file. You might receive a warning about incompatible assets. Don't panic and just select the Update All option. Okay, now let's turn off the light source display. This is just my preference. You can leave it on if you like. Also, don't forget to activate the grid to help you frame your composition. As you can see, everything has already been set up. We have two scenes saved right here. You can activate a specific scene by clicking on the image. For rendering stills, go to the top right corner of your screen and select the first camera icon. Notice that the screen layout has now changed. For rendering animations, you can select the second camera icon. To make an animation sequence, you need to assign at least two reference points. Actually, let's move a bit closer and update our first reference point or frame by clicking on the refresh icon. For the second frame, let's shift our camera towards the right by pressing on the letter D of our keyboard. Just give it a few taps and click on the second frame to store it. You can also change this to Ease Out and this one to Custom. This allows me to manually adjust the desired timing between frames. Again, just a preference. Having the option to check your animation before hitting the render button at high quality preview is pretty cool. Right here, you have the option to adjust your render settings. You can turn on and select which channels you want. For now, let's just leave everything on. You can also choose your output resolution. Let's change it to 4K. Leave it at PNG for now and click on the render button. Let's see how fast this goes. The total rendering time is just above 6 minutes. Now let's create another view. To show you how quick and easy it is to have a high quality render preview, let's go ahead and change our sky and a few settings. Adjust a bit of the framing. And that's it. Save this view. Let's do another test. One PNG and one EXR. Leave everything the same. This one took about 7 minutes of rendering time, including all channels. Now let's render the other one. Okay, we can leave it as is, and it all looks good, but if you want to take it to another step, we can do some post-production editing in Photoshop. Duplicate our base image and label them accordingly. Group all channels into one folder. Again, label it like so and assign a color. Let's mask out and separate the skies, which are currently in color black. Let's add in some adjustment layers on top of our base image layer. Add in the curves, color balance, hue saturation, levels, and photo filters for both cool and warm tones. make use of the grading tool to gradually mask these tones properly. We can go in a bit further to adjust our photo filters in more detail by using a material ID layer and using the magic wand tool to select specific areas like so. Use the brush tool to paint over using the color black to remove or the color white to bring back the mask effect. You can switch between colors by pressing the X key on your keyboard. Change the blending modes of each layer like so. Play around with its opacity to adjust the amount of its effect. Again, don't forget to group your filters into one folder. Turn these layers or groups on and off to review the changes you've made. Let me know if you want to see more contents like this in the future and share it with your friends who might find this video helpful. If it did, give this video a like and subscribe if you haven't already. That's it for me. You guys have a good one. Take care.